At ato o mai at ato abel vi ingo ma fafatai li atua le tai au e au mai ai ma e joi mai ai at ato pesu pesema peo na fai mai ai na salamo ta au a iba skul malima o mai ia i at ato ala lama fia fia i a ioba i at ato ala lama e papa o lota ato o na tama i at ato o atu i o na luma mwane di ingo ia tātou ala langa i ate ia, i pesi. A vea e nei tae au e, tātou whaamua mua le atua i mea uma lava. O na eva ai a lea whamanuianga o le atua i ate oe, i ate au, ia i tātou uma. O na wa tātou mua mua whaamua mua o ina. Ma ame vi ina i atua, a wae ta tau rava i ate ia vi ina.
Thank you.
Ia mato talitonu ia te oe lea tua to tasi pa ino. Ia mato talitonu ilo walo pele o Yesu Keriso lena e awina mai le nangi. Ona olo walofa mo lo walofa muti muti vale ile lano nangi. Na e awina mai ilo walo pele ina ia maliu matoe tu mai o lea lo mato fata tali ilona toe a fio mai. Fa manuia oe ta mama tinao si o mato watu. Fa manuia la wafio e taitai o mato fainga malo. Fa manuia oe inu mala la fanga mola to taitai. Fa manuia oe a inga taitasi mola to taitai. Ta mao le langi peona e a o ao iai mato e tafia mai maunga fa manuia oe. Mato te ole atuai ta mao le langi. Ina ia totole matau i o mato lotu. Totole matau i tutuamu o Samoa i ate oe i le awa marami ngao i a lak bato usi tae mo whanomu ma sava pali lo mato tamai. O awha i whaima o lo ta mo whai e i le li o le neila alo langi i totonu o lo watu. Ta mawe e feta lai, we e a mai le pule ale le suafo i Yesu. E o la vei te moni e fe fefe i le suafo i a. We e mato te tutua i le neitai au ta ma. E mato te whape atu i e tau fia. Le a le le ama lo a ma i mai to tonu. A wai paune ale mena sawele ti apolo. E fa le ama ma fa umatia i hai mato. A oine e sawe a mai le ola ine i a ola i mato. Ma mato wo atu le meo lo a fio ai lo a fio. Ia vi ia nava oe e yoga le tua soifua. E pa ia nava oe e fau vau fau vau nau. Fa manuia mai ela wa fio ele nei mata. I mana oma wa mata o tuvi nata. Fa fitai lava tamai lo fa foma mai. I le suafa lava o Yesu Keriso. O le mata wa li ma le mata o fa aole. Amen em amen.
Hallelujah. Let us give a clap offering to the Lord this wonderful morning. And we thank God that He is here with us. Amen. This next song that we're going to sing. Amen. It says that God is here. He is moving in our midst. Amen. God is everywhere. And the Bible says that as we proclaim His name, as we worship Him, the Bible says that God inhabits the praises of His people. Which means that wherever His name is exalted, wherever His name is glorified, amen, wherever our hearts are in line with God and praising Him, He is there with us this wonderful morning. So as we sing this song, amen, He is here. He is here to touch our hearts. He is here to heal us. He is here, hallelujah, to mend every broken heart and broken lives or whatever situation you may be in. Hallelujah, God is here to meet with you. He is a way maker for us this wonderful. As we sing this song, be blessed. Hallelujah. Let us glorify the name of our Lord Jesus Christ together this wonderful morning.
Isaiah 53 is the greatest single Old Testament chapter prophesying the Messiah's atoning work.
Awal Paula na ta o kule tusi o kenge nga twa ya to a tusi singa ila to wo yai. E a mata pa lebo fai po we ona to fai ku. Wa now Yesu ke vi so lama.
No text in either testament that is the old and the new more completely sets forth the purpose of Christ's death on the cross.
Nei a te sim ta o kolo manino mai yai. E po ku a vati nga ma le to viola na sa ubiye le ka vi so lea. Ole ta na ta sala.
Isaiah 53 is quoted 10 times in the New Testament. Isaiah 53 is a chapter that most of the Jewish scholar likes to avoid.
Why?
Because 700 years before the birth of Jesus Christ, Isaiah pinpointed the sole reason why Jesus Christ came in the first place. Let me just speak three verses from Isaiah 53 and then try to see its prophecy fulfilled in the New Testament. The prophecy in Isaiah 53 verse 3, it says that he will be widely rejected. He is despised and rejected by men. He was a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. He was despised and we did not esteem him. What is the fulfillment in the New Testament? John chapter 12 verse 37 says, but although he had done so many signs before them, they still did not believe him. We rejected Christ when we do not accept the miracles, the signs that he is doing in our lives. Number 2, he will be disfigured by suffering. Verse 2, the Bible says that he has no form of comeliness. And when we see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. What is the fulfillment in the New Testament? Mark 15, verse 17 and 19 says, and they clothed him with purple, and they twisted a crown of thorns, put it on his head. Then they struck him on the head with a reed and spat on him and led him out to crucify him.
Mike to stala mareko, my nalato fa ofu yateia, in ofu, belveta, malato fae yateia, the pale tui tui, malato feanu yateia, fai fai, yateia.
The crown jewel of heaven.
Ole ni never may tapuai, my foy, a woman lami.
Angels worship him in heaven. He came and lived as a man. To the point where he bled and died. The crown of thorn. You cannot see nothing good in him. And the third prophecy that I see, that he will be our substitute. Verses 6 and verse 8, the Bible says, all we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way. And the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. For he was cut off from the land of the living. For the transgression of my people, he was stricken. Second Corinthians chapter 5, verse 21, for the fulfillment. Paul said to the church in Corinth, for he made him who knew no sin to be a sin for us, so that we might become the righteousness of God in him. Can come boldly to the throne and talk to a holy God who is the creator of heaven and earth. Now I want to connect this chapter with Isaiah 54, verse 1. Just the verse. Now we know the reason why Isaiah said in chapter 54 and verse 1, sing. Remember, I asked the question, how can a barren woman sing? A barren woman in Isaiah's time is always a sign of a curse. This is Jewish thinking. And I said to myself, this can be Pacific thinking too sometimes. If you are married, you have to put children to law. And I know sometimes you can be here today. We throw words sometimes, and we care so much for our relative, especially when there is no child that is coming. Probably you hear some words like this: oh, she's just wasting the food. But this is the reality sometimes. You can be laughing and singing and all this stuff, but deep within, it seems like everything you touch died. You can be walking in a workplace. You can be at home. But everything you touch died. Why did Isaiah say for a barren woman to sing? Because it's a shameful act. The only reason why Isaiah said this for the barren woman to sing is this. He has provided the way in Isaiah 53.
in Paul, time of soul, Samata, I must have offended.
I said, after this short sermon, we will see. Sometimes shame, this kind of stuff causes shame. That is why we don't want to talk about it at times. Remember, Jesus was shamed so that you and I can be free. Today is your day. God can take care of the shame that has carried your life. You can see after this short sermon. And today I want to declare to us. And sometimes we can be in the cloud like this, and we are laughing, but deep within we know you are hurt.
I told you, Peru Tau of Mongua, yet Molatu Lamon Tau, yeah, I like to fall in the fear, my son.
I read a story this week. This is a true story that happened in one of the states in the mainland. A young woman who was 18 years old brought up a wonderful family, had a wonderful mom who raised
her.
When she turned 18, that is 2018. When he turned 18, she went to her mom and said, "Mom, I want a driver's license."
You know, was full man on Tausanga, I'm not yet Tausanga on Tina. I mean, if I said that, I said, "You have to."
Because she's 18 years old, she can, and then I want the documents.
Yeah, or she fear, now be a paper for my behavior, was full man on Tausanga for you, like said.
Her mom was a loving mom. She raised this young lady by herself. Because the boyfriend left the mother. And to her, to the young lady, shocked. She was shocked that they when she first heard from her mother. That she is not the real mother. Because she did not have any social security to bear that, because she doesn't have the necessary documents for that for all 18 years. The things that took place. She said, "Your dad was my boyfriend. He abused me. When I was pregnant with you, too low, when I was pregnant, not with her. She kicked her belly. He kicked her belly. By the time they went to the hospital, the baby died. Beside her bed was a 16-year-old girl who just gave birth to this girl. And she was ashamed because of what had happened to her. She took her one of the task called of one of the workers in the hospital and went and brought the daughter of this 16-year-old girl. In the legal term, she was kidnapped.
She was kidnapped. This girl was kidnapped.
Yeah, malele lo. Ole teine le o fa na usulo lo te usana. Sa abe fa malusiya fa maoye se tasi tangata.
Why didn't she go to the next tent? For 18 years she covered up everything. Why? She wanted to save her face. She was ashamed. I don't know who am I speaking to today. Most of the time we cover up all the things inside of us because we want to look good to other people. But way deep within your heart, you know something wrong is happening. The only way to make it right was done 2,000 years ago. He left his
throne.
I'm not calling you to come and join this church. There are already many churches around the territory. But look within your heart and see where you are at. He is a loving God and is waiting for you. Let me tell you, probably you have never bought children. You're in that house. I want to pray for you. God can open that womb. Sing.
My best and I fear the Tokyola.
While all eyes closed, this is a beautiful time for me because heaven is waiting. And I said, Pastor, I need prayer. Don't be ashamed and don't be afraid because eternity is at stake. While all eyes closed, just raise up your hand and say, Pastor, I need prayer. Don't be ashamed. I saw one hand here. Another hand. When you raise your hand, this is the most important part because God knows your heart today. As the worship team, I want you to sing a song. I want you to leave your seat and come. I want to pray with you and pray for you today. I want to pray for you. Those who of you raise your hands. Don't be ashamed. Come.
Jesus, Messiah.
Jesus.